JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for March the 4th. I am Charalambos, Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded higher against all but one of the other G10 currencies on Wednesday and during the Asian session Thursday. It gained the most versus CHF, SEK and NZD, while it was found virtually unchanged against the British pound. Now, the strengthening of the US dollar may have been the result of another rise in bond yields, which suggests that equities may have slid once again. Indeed, turning our gaze to the equity world, we see that although major EU indices ended their session mixed, the US and Asian ones closed in negative waters. In any case, this barely changes our view. We stick to our guns that even if the retreat continues for a while more, equities may eventually rebound as investors start to digest that any spike in inflation this year may prove to be temporary. Now back to the FX world, the pound was the top gainer among the G10s alongside the US dollar. Yesterday, UK Finance Minister Rishi Sunak announced £65 billion of extra stimulus in order to support the nation's pandemic-hit economy. Although this was largely anticipated, what may have come as pleasant news for GBP traders was his statement that the UK economy will regain its pre-pandemic size in the middle of 2022, 6 months earlier than previously forecast. This is in line with our view that following the Brexit Accord and the Bank of England's decision to push back the idea of negative interest rates, the fast vaccination program may allow GBP traders to continue buying pounds. Now, passing the ball to the energy market, today OPEC and major non-OPEC oil producers meet to decide on oil output. OPEC and its allies, known as the OPEC Plus group, cut output by 9.7 million barrels per day last year due to the pandemic hitting demand hard. And as of February, it is still withholding 7.125 million barrels per day. Initially, expectations were for a modest increase of 500,000 barrels per day starting in April, but yesterday sources told Reuters that the group is considering rolling over the existing production cuts into April. Perhaps this was the reason why oil prices rebounded. Now, with that in mind, no action may allow oil prices to continue trending north, while any increase beyond 500,000 may raise concerns over an inventory buildup and thereby be the reason for oil prices to correct lower. As for the rest of today's events, during the European morning, we get the UK construction PMI for February, which is expected to have risen to 51 from 49.2, as well as Eurozone's retail sales for January, which are forecast to have slid 1.1% month over month after rising 2% in December. Later, from the US, we have the initial jobless claims for last week, and expectations are for a small increase to 750,000 from 730,000 the week before. Factory orders for January are also due to be released, and the forecast points to an acceleration to 2.1% month over month from 1.1%. As for the speakers, we have only one on today's agenda, and this is Fed Chair Jerome Powell. We recently heard from him when testifying before Congress, and thus we don't expect him to deviate from what we already know. When testifying, he clearly said that any spike in inflation above 2% in the months to come is likely to prove to be temporary, and that the Fed will not tighten policy in response to that. He also noted that inflation will rise and stay above 2% for some time, which is the goal for beginning normalization in the years after 2023. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the Weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 8 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.